Hello, it's Inder Birdi on behalf of the Keyhole Heart Clinic. I'm glad you could join me today. I'm going to talk to you about aortic valve stenosis. It's a very important condition. It's very common in this country, and it's very important that we pick it up and treat it effectively because it can make a very important difference to long-term outcome and symptoms. Now, what does stenosis mean? I think many of you may well know this if you've seen some of my other videos. Stenosis just means blockage. In aortic stenosis, what it means is the aortic valve, which should normally open very widely and allow blood to flow through it very freely from the left ventricle towards your body, for some reason isn't doing so. And the reason it's not doing so is because the valve is stuck during the opening phase. It's stuck because it's become calcified. Now there are two phases in the population where we see aortic valve stenosis. The first phase is in patients in their 40s or 50s who for one reason or another have been born with a two-leaflet valve in the aortic position instead of a three-leaflet valve. And a two-leaflet valve is much less efficient than a three-leaflet valve. And as a result of that, the eddy currents that are created around that two-leaflet valve over the course of the early life damage that valve. The valve becomes calcified and the lovely thin membranes of that aortic valve become thicker and thicker and thicker and then calcify. And it's a bit like the top end of a toothpaste bottle. When you first buy a toothpaste bottle and you take the lid off and you were to squeeze it hard, the toothpaste hits the ceiling. Same with the heart. After a while, with all the stuff that your husband or me particularly, if you speak to my wife, you know, doesn't clean the top of the toothpaste bottle properly, when you squeeze that toothpaste bottle, nothing comes out the end. Well, it's the same with the aortic valve and aortic valve stenosis. Now, the problem with aortic valve stenosis is that it's so easy to treat, but it's so easy to miss, and that's the importance. Let's talk about the symptoms of aortic valve stenosis. Well, often the first symptoms are shortness of breath, and many patients that you might meet will say, you know, doctor, I thought I was just going old. But, you know, then my doctor picked up a heart murmur and did an echogram, which is this pregnant lady scan of my heart, and picked up this condition called aortic valve stenosis and told me I needed an operation. Well, often that's how people present. Sometimes people present with chest pain, angina, like the sort of thing that people get when their heart arteries aren't working properly, even though the heart arteries might be perfectly normal. And the reason for this is that as that aortic valve tightens, the only way that your body can react is for the muscle in the heart to thicken and thicken and thicken, just like a weight trainer's muscles will thicken and thicken when he picks heavy weights or she picks heavy weights. And of course, that's all right to start with, but after a while, the thickness within the heart, it becomes so large that it outstrips its own blood supply. And so the heart feels like it's getting cramped. And while cramping your arms may not be a big problem, cramping your heart is a very big problem. Now, the beauty with aortic stenosis is that if we treat it effectively, we take away the risk completely, apart from the fact that we'll make you feel a lot better very, very rapidly. And it's one of those conditions that I treat where patients thank me every single time. And it's because we're relieved the way they feel. We've made them new people. We've given them a new lease of life. But actually, I know in my mind, what we've really done for them is made them live longer. Did you know that once you develop symptoms of aortic valve stenosis, you have a 50-50% chance of not being alive in 2 years without treatment. But that if you have treatment, you will live pretty much a normal life. So that's good news, not bad news. So it mustn't be ignored. It's very, very important that this is treated effectively. Now, in terms of treatment, the mainstay of treatment in aortic valve stenosis is surgery. And surgery is associated with very low risk. Our technology today is fantastic, and there are very many ways we can treat your heart valve to relieve this problem. And in fact, we can now do this pretty routinely at the Keyhole Heart Clinic through a very small cut in the breastbone, either top or bottom. And because it's only a small cut, it keeps the breastbone intact and allows you to breathe very freely. It's one of our minimally invasive platform procedures. Now, we can't really repair aortic valve stenosis like we can repair mitral valve regurgitation, if you've seen some of my other videos. Because that calcification is so rigid, like a bone, the only thing we can do is remove the valve. So we'll remove the valve, and traditionally what we'll do is stitch a new valve in there. And there are three main choices that you have these days. There's the tissue valve made out of cow's or pig's valves. These are very good valves. They don't need a blood thinner like warfarin to prevent clots forming on the valve. But the drawback of a tissue valve, of course, is that it can wear and tear. Now, if you're over the age of 70, we would expect the modern day tissue valves to last between 10 and 15 years in 80% of that population of people that we will treat. I think that's very, very good. If you're younger, if you're 40 or 45, then it's very likely, particularly if you are a rugby referee, for example, that you'll wear out a tissue valve very rapidly. And in those situations, you're probably better off with a mechanical valve. A mechanical valve will last forever. Very rarely do mechanical valves ever fail. The only drawback, of course, is warfarin. Warfarin, as you know, is rat poison. It's a tablet you take every day. You need a regular blood test, firstly daily, then maybe twice daily, weekly, then monthly, and then maybe 3 monthly to ensure that your blood is thin to the right amount, not too much, not too less. And that, of course, can become an inconvenience. In the modern era, we're trying to develop new valves, and there is a new valve on the market at the moment called the Onyx valve, ON-X. And you'll read about that valve on the site if you were to look around. We've got some nice information about the valve. This valve is undergoing randomized trials in the US at the moment, in the United States. And we're looking to see whether this carbon valve that has all of the features of a mechanical valve can be treated without warfarin. Now, the trial data is not available to the world yet, so we cannot say that that's the case right now. All we can say right now is that there is evidence to allow us to use warfarin at a lower level of blood thinning with the carbon valve. And of course, if you're going to have treatment for aortic valve stenosis, you should always have this conversation with your heart surgeon, and he'll be able to, or she'll be able to, tell you everything you need to know about the Onyx valve. Now, there are certain groups of patients who are just too high risk for traditional valve surgery, and we couldn't treat them in the old days. But these days, we have got some new treatment strategies that are available. If a patient, for example, is too unwell or too old or too fragile to tolerate traditional heart valve surgery, then we can do something called TAVI. A transfemoral aortic valve implantation. Now, this is a very, very bright scenario where you're put to sleep in a cardiology lab, and through your groin, a new valve in a collapsed manner is passed in through your blood vessel and placed through your diseased valve and opened up. Simple as that. No cuts, just a hole in the groin. Now, how fantastic is that? It is fantastic, but it's not yet available to the general population because it's not shown proven efficacy. And at the moment, the data is telling us that traditional heart valve surgery is still always the best for those people who will tolerate traditional heart valve surgery. And we've gone even further than that now. The Keyhole Heart Clinic and other organizations, there is another technology for those patients who are somewhere in between being not too sick to fit into the groin treatment strategy, but too sick to fit in the traditional valve strategy. And we have a new technology called sutureless valve technology, which is proving to be really very useful for that middle group of individuals, where what we were able to do is traditional heart surgery through a small cut, take out the old valve and put in the new valve without having to stitch it in. And that saves us a huge amount of time during the heart surgery. It reduces the heart-lung bypass time that one of my colleagues, Ben Middleton, will have told you about elsewhere. And by reducing the heart-lung bypass time, we actually reduce the risk. So there's plenty of strategies available for the treatment of aortic valve stenosis. It's a very important condition to diagnose. It's a very important condition to treat. It resolves your symptoms and it will make you live longer. So no need to be afraid. If you need to know anything more about this, speak to your GP, see your hospital doctor. If you want to contact us at the Keyhole Heart Clinic, please feel free to do so.